Hey guys, what's going on? It's me, Destiny, here, and I'm coming to you with a long-awaited fall makeup video, a makeup video period, a video where my face is being shown and where I'm talking to you guys live. I have missed you guys so much. I want to go ahead and just jump right in because I do have a lot of lipsticks to show you guys, and you guys know I like to talk, and I'm going to go around. First, I want to start off with something that I know that everyone's going to be able to get their hands on, something that's inexpensive and very popular here on YouTube. And I want to start out with the LA Girl. These are the glazed lip paints. I'm going to start with the two purples that I feel are going to be the easiest for everyone to be able to pull off. The first one I'm going to show you is called Daring, and I like this because it's a warm purple and it's bright, but it's not something that you're going to have a hard time pulling off. It's not something that's going to be too abstract and too all over the place, too crazy. They're not glittery. There's not anything too much to them except for the fact they're extremely pigmented and they are kind of reminiscent of the Liptars. So that's really, really cool. I'm going to go ahead and show you this color simply because it's beautiful and I feel like a lot of people will be able to pull this color off. So as you can see, this is one of those perfect purple colors that, like I said, most people can pull off. You barely even need a liner. It just glides up there. I wanted to talk to you guys quickly about my cheeks because when you're going to wear or try on several lipsticks, whether you're going shopping or you're doing a video like me, I am wearing a rusty orange blush, and I will have information in the bottom bar, and I'll probably even have information in the video really fast. Okay, so this is the blush that I'm wearing right here, and it's just going to go really nicely. It's kind of a bronzy color, so it's going to go nicely with all these purple lipsticks. This one in particular, you don't necessarily need a liner with, but when you do want to wear a liner, I like to go with a little bit of a darker purple. You can also use brown. But because this is such a vibrant color, I don't want the brown to muddy it up. So I'm going to go in with Bordeaux, and this is from Prestige Lip Liner Company. You guys know I love them. They are the cream of the crop when it comes to drugstore lip liner. They have unique colors. I'm not going to ramble. I'm just going to go ahead and put it on. Okay, so I didn't completely line my lips. I just use it to give my lips a little bit of shade and a little bit of structure. If you want your lips to be thoroughly lined, I do recommend you line your lips first, especially when you're working with something that's liquidy and very creamy, because it's not going to allow that liner payoff to show through. The next color I'm going to show is called Seduce, and this is also a very pretty warm color. I actually haven't even tried this one, but the thing I like about these lip colors from LA Girl is the color on the packaging thoroughly represents the color inside the packaging, the color of the product, which is really good. The only thing is some of the names are really hard to read. What I'm going to do is go ahead and give you a hand swatch for this one. Oh my god, this is so pretty. I honestly think I have to put this on. Even if I only put it on top of this one, they're so pigmented, you will be able to see. So there that is, and that's Seduced on top of Daring. Next, you have two paler purples, and this one is Koi, and this one's Whimsical. And I like these because these are kind of the newer generation, newer popular powder, pastel, kind of pale purples. I really like these a lot because these are the type of colors that are really great when you want to add a center highlight to your lipstick. Like right now, I have pretty much a nice warm base going, and then if I want to add a little bit of a highlight, I'm going to take some of Koi. And place that right in the center of my pout. And then you can kind of see that it helps to give kind of an ombre effect. I am going to swatch this lip color simply so I can show you guys. And there that is right there. And this is Whimsical right here. As you can see, it's even more pale. It's kind of a pinky purple in a way. Sometimes it's really hard having big lips when you want to wear bright colors and colors that bring a lot of attention because, number one, it's easier to get on your teeth. It comes outside of my lip line, and sometimes my lips just look so big and so messy and just all over the place. So, moving directly from LA Girl, I'm going to go into some of my drugstore picks since that's the next easiest for you guys to get. I'm going to go into an all-time favorite if you've been watching my video for a long time. If you've been watching any of my videos from the beginning of my YouTube career, you will know that VaVa Violet used to be a staple of mine. It was my signature. My VaVa Violet, my turban, and my army jacket. Don't front on my turban and my army jacket. This right here is VaVa Violet, though. This is number 663, and this is a Revlon color, and it's a cream color. It's very dark and definitely one of my all-time favorites. So this here on the bottom is VaVa Violet, and I'm gonna put another color on the top so I can give you two swatches for one. And on my top lip, I have Violet Vault from Milani. Now, I do realize that... So on my bottom lip, I have VaVa Violet, and on my top lip, I have Violet Vault. And I love them both. I love VaVa Violet because it's so dark and it's deep. But it's still purple, a blackened purple, but it's one of those colors that if you're daring and you like dark lipsticks, you should definitely give it a try. You can start out with a little bit and then add a little bit more and then go completely nuts like I do. And you can be running around the house with your head spinning with your lipstick on, okay? Because that is just what we do. And I love Violet Vault because it's deep and it's fun. But it's not too juvenile. It's not like a bright Barney purple. It's not one of those purples that you wear and people look at your lips and go. It's nice. It's a plum. It's a violet, as it says. Hello?
Hey, Mom.
Hey, what's going on? Okay, so this really cool lip color that I have on my lips right now is from one of my favorite brands, No Not Lancome Makeup Forever, and this is Rouge Artiste Intense number 15. And I really wanted to show you this really cool lip color because it's a purple with a frost, slightly a blue duochrome. It's very interesting. It's very comfortable to wear. It's not too glossy. I am leaning more toward matte lips. You know, lately, not even just this season, lately for any season, I am moving more toward a matte lip simply because my lips just get so messy when they're glossy sometimes. I end up with lipstick on my nose, on my chin, on my cheek. Before you know it, I'm getting undressed. I got lipstick on my socks, had a lipstick get over here, a lipstick sticking, hair blowing. It's just too much. But this is a really beautiful color and it's really, really easy to wear. And I wanted to show you a little bit of a top coat simply because this is more of a satin finish, kind of a sparkle matte, if you will. Very comfortable, however. And I wanted to add some 3D glitzy gloss on top of the lipstick. If you guys have been following me for any length of time, more than 2 years, you guys probably know that I once had a major addiction to these. I have every single one. And you know what would be really cool on this lipstick? Not only this one, but the blue one. So let me see if I can find my blue one. So the name of this one is called Fashion Diva, and it's really pretty, and it's like purple, and it has all these beautiful sparkles in there and all these colors. And then the name of the blue one, I don't even know. I don't even have the name of it. I will have the name in the video or in the bottom bar so you guys can check it out. But instead of using Fashion Diva, I want to go ahead and just use the blue one, which actually does have some purple glitter in there. I'm just going to go ahead and put that on the back of my hand. Let's see how this baby does. It really goes in and it picks up that blue. It really does. And in case you are not gagging over this lip brush yet, honey, this is the detail brush from Real Techniques, and it is perfect, especially if you're a person with fuller lips, because sometimes some lip brushes are just tiny and you're up there for 11 hours painting your lips and it just takes too long. So I really, really like this one a lot. And I really like how that glitter adds that really cool kind of intergalactic galaxy, very edgy look to the lipstick. It's really cool. Okay, so next I'm going to be applying one of my pale purple tones. And what I want to do is show you how I like to line my lips when I'm going to use one of the paler purple shades. This is Parisian Plum from Giordano Lip Liner, and I'm going to line my lips with this, and then I'm going to fill it in. Okay, so now that I have that up there, I'm going to go in and fill it in with Illumasqua's Tantrum, which is a beautiful pale blue purple tone. Okay guys, so there you go. I absolutely love this tone. It's super cool. It's a pale purple tone and I really love the unique kind of color of it, and I really love the comfort of the wear. Okay, so the lip color that I have on my lips right now is actually a Liptar called Lydia. And I like this because this is a great purple for brown skinned women. You're a little bit lighter than me, yet you're not completely out of the realm where you want to wear maybe a really, really yellow purple or a really, really bright purple or a really, really Barney purple. This is a very safe, my lip tone, but better purple with less brown. It's a pale raisin tone in my opinion, and it's really, really pretty and really safe. And it says my lips are purple, but they're not pastel and they're not Barney. It's like right in the middle. Just a very, very pretty, very nice, fun tone to wear for people who maybe haven't completely made the transition to being all out balls against the wall, but a great option nonetheless. Okay guys, so right now on my lips, I have another lip tar that I really like, and it's called Dekadent, and I like it because it's purple, but it's not super opaque. It does let some lip color show through. It's not completely obnoxious or show-stopping or neck-breaking, but it's very pretty. It's an obvious, really pretty color that's on the lips, and I like it for that reason. If you have a little bit more yellow in your skin, like a very obvious yellow, if you consider yourself yellow, this is going to be a great purple from you. I'm going to go ahead and layer that on top so you guys can check out what it does together. So as you can see, that adds a lot of warmth to my look. It really adds a lot of life to my face. A lot of times when I'm looking for a little bit of oomph, or I'm looking for a little bit more brightness, a warm color really brings the sun in, really brings out the yellow tones, the warm undertones in my skin, and really helps to just wake my face up. And this is from the CoverGirl Colorlicious line, and this is called Pinklicious. I think it's a little bit more toward a purple, but either way, it's a really, really pretty tone. All right, guys, as always, I'm gonna get out of here. This is a really, really, really fun video. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know if you have any questions, any comments, any concerns. I have my email in the bottom bar, and I will have lots of other links and different things for you guys to go ahead and check out. Don't forget to go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. You can like me on Facebook. You can follow me on Instagram and all that good stuff. I'm going to go ahead and get out of here, guys. As always, I want to thank you so, so much for your comment, for your support, and thank you so much for subscribing. I'll be in touch, and hopefully you'll do the same. Bye, guys. So moving from LA girl, I'm going to go directly. So moving from CoverGirl, it's not CoverGirl either.